In this video, we're going to take a look at what's new with Safari on the iPhone with iOS 16. We can now create different start pages for our tab groups. We can pin tabs in our tab groups, and we can create shared tab groups. As you can see, there's a lot with tab groups. We can also sync our different website settings, and we can sync our extensions, as long as that extension is available on all of your different devices. Let's take a look at these new features on the iPhone. Let's first take a quick refresher of what tab groups are, since there are a lot of new features with tab groups. With tab groups, what we're able to do is open up each one of these tabs. These are tabs here. These are all of my different websites that I have open in Safari. If I go and tap on Done here in the lower right-hand corner, I can see all of my different sites by just swiping over to the left or right. These are tabs. And when I tap on the two squares in the lower right-hand corner, I can see all of those different tabs. Well, we can see that I have a lot of different tabs open here in Safari. What I would like to do is group these together. That's what tab groups does. I can group all of my work websites together in a work tab group. I can group all of my personal websites together in a personal tab group. I can put all of my school websites together in a school tab group. And then when you want to look at those websites, you just go to that tab group. So you're going to see down at the bottom here, I have 10 tabs. When I tap on this, I can see all of my tab groups. I have here dance tutorials. This is a shared tab group. I'll talk about that in a little bit. This is what's new in iOS 16. I have here home, school, and work. And if I want to create a new tab group, I just go down in the bottom and I can go and create a new tab group. To add a website to a tab group, I just open it up. So let's go over to school here. And if I want to add a website, I just go over to the plus here and it'll add it to that tab group. I switch to a different tab group, I will not see that website. So that's the idea behind tab groups. We can group all of our different websites together into a group. So now let's get back to what's new in iOS 16. What we can do is we can create separate start pages for our tab groups. Now, if you're not familiar with start pages, when we create a new page here, I'm going to tap on the plus. What it does is it opens up to a start page. And with the start page, what we're able to do is customize the background. And when we tap on edit here, I can customize what information is shown here. So this start page here does not show my reading list. It does not show my recently closed tabs. And it does not show Siri suggestions. I can also switch the background. We can see it has a butterfly on it. Let's go and change it to a panda bear. And now when I tap on the X in the upper right-hand corner, any changes I've made are going to be applied. Well, now what we're able to do is create different start pages for different tab groups. In the past, when we created or edited a start page, it edited it for all of the different tab groups. So now when I go back over to edit here and I customize this start page, when I go to a different tab group, I can customize it differently. So let's go over to a different tab group. I tap on the two squares. And what we're going to do is go over to school here, and I'm going to switch it to work. The first thing you'll see is the start pages have changed. They're butterflies. Let's go and add a new page, and I'm going to edit this. And let's say for the work, what I wanted to have was my recently closed tabs, and I wanted to show my reading list. I tap on the X, and now those changes are applied. We can also pin tabs. When I go down to the two squares here, I can see all of my different tabs. So if we look up at the top here, you're going to see that I have one that is pinned. When we pin a website, it always shows at the top, so we have easy access to it. So I could have 20 or 30 websites open in this tab group. Well, if there is a website that I need to access quite a bit, what I may want to do is pin it so it's always at the top. Now, it does not bookmark it. If you delete it, it will not be in your tab group anymore. So just remember, it is not a bookmark. But what it does do is it pins it up to the top. So how do we do that? Well, basically, we go to the website. So let's go over to Apple here. And what I would like to do is pin this. So now I just tap on my two squares to view all of my different tabs. And then we go over to this website here and I long press on it, and then you're going to see pin tab. All I have to do is just tap on it, and now we can see that Apple is pinned up at the top. So what I'm able to do now is pin my favorite websites, websites that I need to access in that specific tab group to the top of that tab group. If I were to switch to a different tab group, I would see different pins. Now let's take a look at shared tab groups. With shared tab groups, what we're able to do is share a tab group with other users. If we go back down to my tab groups here, I'm going to tap on school. What you're going to see is dance tutorials here. And you're going to see that the icon has changed. This is a shared tab group. So now what I'm going to do is show my personal iPhone, which I'm sharing this tab group with, side by side here. So let's go over to my personal iPhone along with this demo iPhone. So now we're looking at my personal iPhone on the left, and I have my demo iPhone here on the right. So when we look at this, I'm going to tap on done here, and we're going to go to the shared tab group. I'll show you how you share it shortly, but we're going to go to this shared tab group. We can see that they both have two tabs. What I'm going to do is add a new tab on this iPhone here, the one on the right, the demo iPhone. When I do that, watch what happens. So we can see we have three tabs there. Now watch what happens on my personal iPhone. We now have that third page there. If I go and delete it from my demo iPhone, let's go ahead and delete it. What it's going to do is remove it from my personal iPhone, and there it goes. So now what we're able to do is share tab groups with other people. So if you're going on a trip with someone, what you may want to do is share a tab group with them. Maybe you put websites in there where you want to go on that trip. You can share that tab group. You can share those websites. So how do we do that? Well, basically all we have to do is open up the tab group. So I'm going to go down to the bottom here. And then let's say I wanted to share my school tab group with other people that I work with. So what I do is I tap and hold on this, and then you're going to see share. When I tap on share, what I'm able to do is share this with other people. I can send it to them in a message as an example. So I would send this to my coworkers in a message, and then once they open it up, they're going to have that shared tab group in Safari. So that's how we share our tab groups. What else do we have? Well, we can sync our website settings. So what do I mean by that? Well, when you are visiting a website, I'm going to go and visit a website here. Let's go to my 10 tabs. We're going to go to Apple here. And when we go down to the bottom where we have these double A's here, when I tap on it, I get various settings. You're going to see I have website settings. When I tap on this, what I'm able to do is customize Safari for this website. So I can request a desktop website. I can use the reader view automatically for this website, which is great for news sites. I can allow it to access the camera, the microphone, and the location. And what I'm also able to do is, when I tap on it again, is change the size. Well, any changes that I make to this website will now be synced with my other devices. So if I were to open this up on my iPad, any changes that I make to these settings, to these website settings, when I go to Apple on my iPad, it's going to have those same settings. So it's going to sync all of these different settings. I could go to the Washington Post, turn on Reader View, and then when I go to my iPad, Reader View will be turned on automatically because it's syncing those settings. So again, all we have to do is just go down to these double A's to make any changes. In addition to that, we also have extension syncing. Now with extensions, what I'm going to do is go to settings here. And then what we need to do is go to Safari. With extensions, what we're able to do is extend the functionality of Safari. We could put ad blockers on there as an example. When we go over to our settings here, you're going to see I have extensions. And now what I'm able to do is share those extensions across my different devices. So I only have to install it on one device. And once I install it on that one device, so in this case here, I install it on my iPhone. when I go to my iPad, as long as I'm sharing my extensions across my devices, that extension will also be on my iPad. Now, of course, the extension does have to be available on the iPad and the iPhone and the Mac for it to share across all your different devices. And not all extensions are able to be installed on all of your different devices. So you have to be a little careful with that. But if that extension is available on the Mac, iPad, and iPhone, or even the iPad and iPhone, what you are now able to do is install it on one device, and then it'll install it on the other devices automatically. And here's the little bonus tip that we have with Safari and iOS 16. With Safari tab groups, what we can also do is assign them to a focus. So let's go back over to the school. Let's go back over to Safari here. And when I go down to the two squares here, what I'm able to do is switch over to a specific tab group. So when I go to the school, this is what I have to do. I have to switch over to that tab group. Well, as you can see, there's a few different steps in there. Well, now what we can do is we can assign a tab group to a focus. So I have a focus, which is basically customized Do Not Disturb for school. So I'm going to go to my settings here. And then what we need to do, go back. We need to take a look at our focus. You're going to see that I have a focus for school. So basically what's going to happen when I go to the school is it's going to allow notifications from specific apps and from specific people. Well, in addition to that, what I can do is I can have it open up to a tab group when I enter that focus. So I'm going to go to school here. And when I swipe up, you're going to see we have focus filters. This is what is new with iOS 16. And one of them is tab group. So I just tap on this. And what I'd like to do when I'm at the school is go to my school tab group. So now when I'm at the school, when I open up Safari, what is it going to do? It's going to go to that tab group. When I leave the school, the focus will turn off because I have it set to turn on automatically. When I leave the school, when I open up Safari, it will no longer go to that tab group. I could have it assigned to a different tab group. So that's a little bonus tip there for your tab groups. We can now assign a tab group to a focus. So that is what's new with Safari on the iPhone with iOS 16. As you can see, we have a lot with tab groups. Apple is really expanding on that tab group. We can share tab groups. We can assign a start page to a tab group. We can pin tabs in a tab group. We can also assign a tab group to a focus. We can also sync our different website settings across all our different devices, and we can sync our extensions. So that's what's new with Safari with iOS 16 on the iPhone.